Hi darlings, it's me, Christine D'Amore, and as you guys know, I usually don't like to do super long intros, but today I have a special guest, my girl here, Shannon Rose. So if you guys are just coming over from Shannon's channel, welcome Rose fam to our darling little family. Today we're going to be doing something different for both of our channels, and we are going to be talking about our actual real haunted houses that we did both live in. And just make sure that you guys go ahead and head over to Shannon's channel. If you guys haven't seen her channel before, she's literally the reason why I started sharing my life experiences with all of you guys. Seriously. So if you guys have been enjoying my story times, thank her because she's the reason behind all of that.
So sweet.
So if you guys are entertained by my videos, you ain't seen nothing yet. So head over there.
And we also did a collab on my channel where we called psychics and it was like really crazy.
Yeah. You guys cannot miss that one. To me, I don't feel like we lived in normal haunted houses that were haunted by these humanly ghosts. I felt like something that was in both of our houses was a little bit darker and something very scary straight out of a horror movie. To cancel out a little bit of the creepy factor, we have some vegan food because in addition to being haunted, we are both vegan. So we're just gonna be chowing down, telling these crazy ghost stories. Alrighty, my darling, so we're just gonna go ahead and dive right into the reason why you are all here to hear our haunted story times.
Can we eat? Like, I'm pregnant and hungry. So this place is so good. They have like all really good, like fresh vegan food. And this is their like Tiger Mountain Burger. Okay. It's kind of messy though. So you guys are gonna see our faces getting kind of messy. Do you remember how messy this is?
Yeah, but that's okay.
We got like a brownie and then like pudding.
Is this pudding? Thing. I thought this was beans.
No.
It looks like beans.
It's probably made with beans.
What? Yeah, we're super crazy healthy like that.
Yeah, so. Well, she's more healthy than I am. Okay, so I'm gonna tell you guys about my haunted house story. In fact, I've told multiple haunted house stories on my channel. There's so much that has happened like at that house. So there's like multiple videos, but I'm gonna sum up in this video what all five videos would be. And if you guys want more details, you guys can like check that out on my channel. I try not to think about it because it's really scary. When I was younger, I had bought my very first house. And I was like so proud of myself. I ended up moving into this house. I had no idea like anything was wrong with it. It looked so cute. It was like the cutest house ever. I was going to college at the time and I didn't want to have to pay the full mortgage on my own. So I was like, I'm gonna get roommates. I ended up getting a bunch of roommates to fill out the house with me. Mm-hmm. Over time, these roommates would move in and out, move in and out, move in and out. Like I never had like consistent roommates. Like it started to get to the point where I was like, do I like smell or something? I probably do smell right now though, because that psychic video that we just did literally made me sweat.
No, we were sweating like crazy.
Yeah, no, but I thought there was something wrong with me. I was like, oh my God, like people don't like me. Like they don't like living with me because so many people kept moving out. Eventually I had these two girls move in and they kind of remind me a little bit of you. We all like got along really well and we like hit it off. And those girls stayed a little bit longer. What happened was one night, one of the girls had said something about like, she was like, yeah, like have you had like any like weird experiences in this house? And then like, I guess like the other girl started talking like to each other, the two roommates.
Oh, the two roommates,
Yeah. The roommates started talking to each other about like weird stuff happening
in the
house.
Were they telling you, keeping you in the conversation?
So not at first, like I think they kind of like talked about it first, and then one of them had come up to me and was like, has anybody like said anything about like weird stuff happening in your house? And I was just like, no. And I had like a back house, like a guest house that I would stay in. There was different times where like I had stayed in the house, but then I like stayed in the guest house.
Okay.
Make a long story short, all of these roommates had been moving out because something was scaring them so bad to the point where not just like one person or two people got scared, but like multiple people had been so scared by whatever was going on in the house, and no one was saying anything to anybody because they didn't want people to think they're crazy.
Yeah.
Something that I personally experienced, I had like a whole wall of crosses like in the hallway. I had like collected them from all over. I was not religious, I just thought they looked cool. The cross wall, like one of the crosses had turned upside down on the cross wall. They were hammered in, like one at the top and two at the sides. So it wasn't like it was easy to like turn over, but like some weird things like that would happen, like loud banging and noises. So this is like the scary part. So I decided to call in like a paranormal team, and they like came to the house, and there was like a bunch of them. They came to the house and did like a whole investigation. They're supposed to come back 3 days later, like after they figure everything out. The girl that was in charge of everything wouldn't come back to my house. Like, she was so scared that of whatever they found. And then like the other people didn't really want to come back, but they basically told me the house behind me, like catty corner to the house behind me, the guy like shot and killed his whole family and then like killed himself and like killed a cop. Yeah, like you could look over the fence and see the house, and it was abandoned. Like, it still was abandoned even when I lived there.
So it was over the fence from where you live.
Yeah, get this. This is the even better part. We had lots of roommates over all the time, and I lived in this guest house. So there was this guy in the backyard, and I was just like, hey, what's up? And like, he never really said anything to me. I thought it was just kind of weird, but I just assumed it was like one of my roommate's friends like going out to smoke or something in the backyard. I got like a weird vibe from him, right? So then like I had gone into the house and I was like, who's your friend or something? And they were like, well, I don't have any friends over. Yeah. I just assumed it was like one of the other roommate's friends or something. Well, after the investigation happened, they went and showed me pictures of like the guy that ended up killing his whole family. I looked at that picture and I literally, like when a roller coaster goes and your like stomach feels like it's in your chest, like I literally had that feeling because it was the same guy. I talked to like the killer of the family and he's dead. Like, he doesn't exist, but he was in my backyard and I like said hi to him and I could like see him.
Oh my God.
Yeah. It wasn't like a ghost figure. It was like you and me. What? It was like a real person.
So he looks solid.
Yeah.
Like with dimension and everything.
Yeah, no, I thought it was like my roommate's friend. It was literally the same guy that shot and killed his whole family. Paranormal investigators were like, spirits can like move places. One of my roommates was like trying to get spirit guides on this board or whatever, and I think that she brought.
No. Yeah. First of all, that upside down cross thing is evil.
It wasn't just like one thing. I think that that was there, the kid, but I think that there was more than just like one thing in my house.
Okay, so there's the ghost. Do you think that the evil came from a guy, or did all that crazy stuff happen after she brought the...
So some of the stuff was happening beforehand, but it got worse and worse after she left. And she ended up throwing that like board. It wasn't a Ouija board. It was like a spirit board.
Is that the same thing though? No.
Pretty much. There's so many stories that like it would just take too long for me to tell you everything. She basically used a spirit board. She kept asking me if I wanted to use it with her when she lived there, and I was like, no way. Well, I was really drunk one night and she asked me and I agreed to do it because I was really wasted. A bunch of bad stuff happened. She ended up throwing the board away. Didn't tell us she threw it away. Mm-hmm. It ended up back in her room after she had thrown it away. She came out and she was like, who took the board out of the trash and put it back in my room? And I looked at her and I was like, oh, hell no, bitch.
Nope.
She ended up moving out and she left the board in my garage.
What's wrong with you?
And I ended up having to sell the house because it was so haunted. My mom would not go in that house by herself. She had someone whisper in her ear in the bathroom and she literally ran out and she was so scared. My dad, who's like macho, like Harley Davidson, slept in my back house. He thought that we were like messing with him one night. He like heard like knocking on the window and on the roof. He felt some weird thing come over his body and like go inside of him.
I wonder if he was like hearing the knocks of threes. When you hear those three knocks, anything paranormal, if it comes in threes, it's the devil trying to like humiliate the Holy Trinity.
Oh, I have no idea, but my dad doesn't believe in stuff like that. And he was like, your house is haunted. When we went to sell the house, my mom literally took lawn chairs and sat in the front yard because she wouldn't go in the house. The end of that story is we ended up selling that haunted house, but I will forever have those memories.
A lot of you guys wish to experience haunted houses, hence all these people going out and trying to do amateur ghost hunts. If you live it, you will wish that you've never experienced could get just as bad as what you see in movies.
Or worse.
It all started like when my parents moved to this brand new house, new development, fresh land. It didn't take very long to start feeling those feelings of somebody being in there, but just not seeing anybody. But the first thing that actually did happen was my grandma had passed away and my whole entire family had to go to the Philippines to go to her funeral. Before my family left the airport to go to the Philippines, my sister had built this Lego tower. My mom came back a couple weeks later, asked me if I had come over to the house at all during the time that she was gone, and I said no. There's no reason for me to come out there. It takes 45 minutes to drive and you're not there. So she didn't believe me, but she tells me that first of all, Lexini, my daughter's toys, were just placed in a circle on top of my old bed in that house. And she said, I had left all of the beds completely done. Every single bed in that house, the sheets was just crumbled up together. The bed sheets were just messed up. The pillows were just thrown about.
Like they trashed the bedding on all
right.
the rooms?
Like somebody just went to all the beds and just went like that. And the third thing that really stuck out to me was the fact that my sister's Lego tower had not only been knocked over, but every single piece was pieced apart. One of the second major things that happened was my mom would actually start waking up with scratches on her stomach, but they were scratches in letter and number forms.
Oh man, that would have freaked me out.
The next major thing that happened was my mom had woken up one morning because she felt something tapping her leg. She thought it was a dream, so she just closed her eyes but didn't fully fall asleep. She felt the tapping again, and then she woke up pissed because she thought that my little sisters were messing with her. So she darted up from the bed and just yelled, "Alex, Angie!" She looks around the bed, nobody's there.
Yes, I could actually feel it, and I opened my eyes and nobody there, and I was scared.
She shakes my dad next to her, wakes him up, tells him what happened, and he's looking around the room too. They hear this loud crash to their right, and they just see the blinds in the window outside of their room swayed back and forth like this. But it didn't stop. That's the thing. If something had just quickly hit it, it would have stopped at one point.
Right.
Something was there brushing those blinds back and forth, back and forth, back and forth. So they watched that for about 5 minutes long.
I'd be watching, I'd be running.
So when I came over, and it was not only my mom telling me, but my dad telling me, because as you know, dads, they don't buy into that kind of
right.
crap. But when my dad was confirming all of this, I freaked out a little bit. From then on, we continued getting a lot of negative things. And I do have a series up on my channel about my haunted house, and I am wrapping up the series. It's going to be the very last one where I'm going to like reveal what actually happened with my parents, because I feel like whatever was there, honestly, I feel like that's what broke them apart. And like, yeah, like it got crazy. And my mom probably doesn't want me sharing every single detail, but I'll share as much as I can. It was more than one person on two different occasions that saw who this person was. It was head, shoulders, red eyes, completely black silhouette, dark shadow, moving like it was on a track, like it was floating.
I have like the chills.
I'm gonna just share one more major thing that happened. Chris had told this story in one of my videos, but we had been spending the night there for the holidays, and Chris got up in the middle of the night because he wanted to check on his car. Chris is my husband, by the way. And he wanted to check on his car because a lot of houses were getting broken into because a lot of the holidays. So we checked on the car. He came back into the room. He turned around and shut the door where we were both sleeping. And there was a big window right in front of him, the moonlight shining through. But as he turns towards the window, he sees a head and shoulders blocking out the moonlight coming through the window.
Oh, hell no.
That head and shoulders is standing there in the corner, seemingly like watching me sleep. As soon as Chris like notices it, it just dashed straight across the window, blocking the moonlight, and came directly towards him.
From outside the window?
No, from inside. So it was inside,
it was
in the room with us. But
what did he do?
Standing at the corner, he freaked the f- He said that he wanted to wake me up, but he knew that I would want to leave. So he didn't tell me until like the
next
morning.
Was he able to sleep that night?
No.
Poor guy.
I know.
Oh, guys, our husbands are so good to us, right?
Yeah.
That is so, so scary.
It's very scary. Like, this stuff is real.
Yeah. Ghosts are real, guys.
But not, I mean, I don't think that we had ghosts.
No, it was like evil. Worse. Yeah, we had like evil in our houses.
Yeah. I mean, like Shannon said, there's a lot more to the story.
Yeah.
You guys can just watch the rest of both of our videos.
I feel like when you live in a haunted house, like so much happens that like you can't tell it in one story time. So there has to be like tons of different videos to like tell individual stories to give you guys like really, but we do, we have like,
so much.
Yeah.
The whole time when we were there, I had known nothing about like demons or like the fact that they could be on this planet, like haunting just like any other ghost. One more thing that happened was that I ended up realizing that this thing was evil. Upon doing these videos, I started researching a little bit. So when I typed in search, I typed in Shadow Man, and it brought up all of these articles stating that if you see this kind of dark shadowy figure, it is demonic and it brings bad luck to your house. And in some cases it could bring something that I don't want to say. Describes them as over 6 feet tall, sometimes even 7 feet tall, and sometimes they have red eyes. My mom and Chris both described this as being extremely tall, and my sister told me that she saw red eyes. So that was pretty much confirmation right there that we weren't dealing with something human at all. And I'm going there tomorrow.
Crazy.
I know, I'm like gonna regret it. Like I woke up in the middle of the night and I was like, man, maybe I shouldn't go there. Cause what if that thing is like waiting and like realizes that I'm back?
Make sure you have the vlog camera turned on.
Would you ever play with the Ouija board?
With you? I have it.
No, you don't. No, you don't.
No, literally someone sent it to me and it's right there in that box. Do you see it? The box all the way to left.
That's the Ouija board?
It's not open, but yeah. Come back over for Halloween time. I would totally play it with you. No one else. I'm really scared.
Me too.
Oh no, I did play the Ouija board with Travis actually for Halloween apartment, but I only did it because I knew we were moving out of that apartment.
Oh, maybe we shouldn't do it here then.
Well, we can take it somewhere, like out of the house, and maybe go to like a park or something at night.
Okay.
And put candles and then play it.
Ooh.
Subscribe
in the cemetery.
Yeah. Oh, even better.
Subscribe to both of our channels because we're gonna be updating on them. Yeah. I like warn so many people about it because I never hear anything good come out of it.
No.
But we're looking what we're doing.
I know. We're like calling psychics and doing all kinds of stuff we shouldn't be doing. That we know we shouldn't be doing.
Mm-hmm. Alrighty, my darlings, thank you so much for watching. I hope that you enjoyed both of our crazy haunted storytime videos. If you haven't already, go ahead and head over to Shannon's channel and make sure that you subscribe. If you want to see us both back together again for more videos, go ahead and comment down below and make sure that you like the video as well. And also suggest any video ideas that you want for both of our channels as well. As always, we love you so much, darlings, and we will talk to you later. Bye, darlings.
Bye. Mwah.